Today's my topic for case study is olaratumab. So let us start. Olaratumab, the brand name for olaratumab is Latuvu. The generic name is olaratumab. It is a fully human immunoglobulin G1 monoclonal antibody. Its basic mechanism is it blocks platelet-derived growth factor receptor alpha, that is PGDFR alpha, and it is used in the treatment of soft tissue sarcoma. It was first approved by in October 19, 2016, and it was discovered by company Eli Lilly, and its initial name is this. And the molecular formula for olaratumab is this, and the molar mass is 154 kilodalton. Now, mechanism of action for olaratumab: it inhibits the growth of tumor cells by blocking the PGDFR alpha, and the PGDFR alpha is a type of tyrosine kinase, so indirectly it is a tyrosine kinase inhibitor. So olaratumab selectively it binds to PGDFR with high affinity. So instead of ligand binding, the olaratumab is going to bind with PGDFR alpha, and hence the binding is inhibited and further the cell growth is inhibited. So this is the cycle. These are the ligands PGDFAA, this is BB and ABCC. So olaratumab, instead of these ligands, olaratumab is going to bind with receptor, and hence the further proliferation and survival cycles, these are the cascade cycles, so these are going to be blocked. So hence the cell growth would be stopped. And this is the structure for olaratumab, which is a monoclonal antibody. And these are the drug development strategies. So targeting PGDFR as therapeutic strategy, it was a bit complex in the starting. So the co-expression of PGDF and PGDFR alpha in multiple cancer type, as well as gene amplification and activation of PGDFR alpha, provides evidence for the presence of autocrine growth, and it is also used in melanoma cells. So at the end, the disruption of the PGDF and PGDFR pathway may be reasonable for anti-cancer strategy. So this is how it was developed. Now, preclinical studies, there were 5 novel antibodies along with along with olaratumab, which were there in the preclinical studies, which were used for inhibiting PGDFR, and they were vigorous in vitro evaluation. Olaratumab demonstrated strong blocking activity inhibiting receptor binding when exposed to PGDFAA and PGDFBB respectively. And in this study, all antibodies were evaluated for downstream effects inhibiting ligand induced receptor phosphorylation. So olaratumab demonstrated the strongest inhibition in response to PGDFBB, hence it was taken for further studies. In vivo evaluations were also performed in this cancer cells. Now, clinical development, phase 1 study in advanced solid tumors. This drug was administered intravenously either weekly or bi-weekly. There was no dose limiting toxicities which were observed during the study, hence the maximum tolerated dose was not reached. The most common drug related adverse events were fatigue and infusion reactions. And in phase 2 study, which was open label and randomized, the olaratumab, it was given with doxorubicin, and the patients with unresectable or metastatic soft tissue sarcoma. So US FDA further approved Latuvu, that is olaratumab, based on the results obtained from this trial, which was randomized open label and phase 2 study conducted to evaluate the safety and efficacy of this drug in combination with doxorubicin. And in this trial, there were 133 adult patients who were suffering from this cancer. So they were given Latuvu with doxorubicin or only doxorubicin during the right cycles of the trial. Each cycle of the trial was termed for 21 days. survival, progression-free survival, and overall objective response rate endpoints. And the median of overall survival for latrupone plus doxorubicin was 26.5 months compared to 14.7 months for the doxorubicin arm. So the confirmatory trial, which was called as ANNOUNCE, is currently ongoing to evaluate the safety and efficacy of doxorubicin with olaratumab compared to only doxorubicin with placebo. So the randomized phase 3 placebo controlled double-blind trial is being conducted on 460 patients with advanced or metastatic soft tissue sarcoma. Now, drug product development. The drug is available as 10 mg per ml injection, which is intravenous injection, and it is administered in combination with doxorubicin for up to 8 cycles of treatment, and which is later followed by only olaratumab monotherapy. The recommended dose of olaratumab is 15 mg per kg administered by IV infusion on day 1 and day 8 of each 3-week cycle until the disease progression or unacceptable toxicity. Now, manufacturing process development. A comparability exercise was performed to demonstrate comparability of active substance manufacturing processes and batches during development. Now, this comparability assessment was to support changes consisted the application of a battery of analytical test to active substances sample. Now, analytical testing, this comprised of routine active substance release test and additional biochemical characterization assays. Now, the test results were compared qualitatively, wherein which was appropriate, and also quantitatively. And the most common side effects of olaratumab and doxorubicin are nausea, fatigue, musculoskeletal pain, mucositis, alopecia, which is a lot of hair fall, and vomiting, diarrhea, decreased appetite, abdominal.